His morning crew with Rob,
Allison,
and Jim.
Just about ending his day in South Korea is Nigel Robertson, who gets to cover for NBC on about 31 stations what the Olympics is doing. I mean, you're right at the Olympic Village, Nigel.
Yeah, I'm right in the heart of it all the excitement. Getting to meet the athletes, getting to see the venues, getting to tell stories for stations around the country. It's a huge blessing, and I'm excited to be here.
Oh, so awesome. I love following you on Instagram, Nigel, and I love how you're diving into the culture of South Korea, and you say they deep fry and batter anything and everything, so I got to know, what's the weirdest thing you've eaten so far?
Well, here's the thing. I kind of whipped out. We went on a food tour in Seoul yesterday, and I tried all kinds of delicious foods and cold noodle soup, which, you know, normally I like hot soup. But so we went to an outdoor market that literally fries everything, and they had, you know, shrimp and chicken and vegetables, but they had octopus and snails and other things that I had no idea what it was, and I wasn't about to try it.
I noticed they're doing something in South Korea at the Olympics, like they do at Disney, and they trade pins.
Yeah, pin trading is huge here. So I work for Hearst Television, which owns, you know, WYFF4. So I'm here for all the Hearst stations, and we have pins that, you know, when you go up to someone from another station or another country, another company, they all come here stocked with pins, and it's a huge trading thing. And then the Olympic Games has tons of pins as well. So when I was in Rio, it was for the Summer Games in 2016, that was the first time that I was introduced to pin trading on the international level, and it's pretty epic.
How many do you have now?
Probably have about 20. You know, and I've got my favorites. I probably have five or so favorites that I refuse to trade. But on my lanyard, I'll have, you know, pins. So our credentials is hanging on a lanyard, and everyone puts their pins on the lanyard. So as you're walking around, you can see other people's pins and you know, then trade accordingly. But, yeah, I've got about five that I'm keeping, definitely bringing home.
Okay, I got to be honest with you. I don't get curling, but you covered curling at the Olympics, and you met Matt and Becca Hamilton, like is like a brother and sister in the curling event.
Yeah, and I gave them the Palmetto Curling Club pin, and they wore it all the time, even on TV, which was awesome.
That is so cool.
But they're great. They're great, and their story is amazing. And that's what's so awesome about the games is. You know, people give up their lives and focus on a goal to make it to the Olympic Games and become the best in their sport. And through that entire journey, the ups and the downs, the sacrifices they make, I get to sit down and talk to them when they're on the biggest stage in the world.
Yeah.
And ask them how they got here and ask them, you know, who helped you get here, their faith, the sacrifices they made. It's just, and then I get to tell you the stories, and then, you know, that's a blessing for me, and there's so many stories that I don't get to tell, you know. So I spend every minute of the day while I'm here just trying to find one story after another.
Well, talk about sacrifices. You are away from your family for almost a whole month, and I know you have three precious boys. So anything you want to say to them back home here?
I love to death. We FaceTime as much as possible and talk, and my wife's doing an amazing job with them. So, and then our friends and neighbors have the food and, you know, just taking care of my family. So I'm so grateful. You know, we have no blood family in the upstate, so our friends have truly become our family, and they're awesome.
Oh, that's so cool. We love you, Nigel. I'm glad you checked in with us live from the Olympic Village. How cool
awesome.
Is that?
That's pretty cool.